How many sales do you need to get your music into the charts? Let's break it down. Breaking into the charts is a surefire way to help your music career, your momentum, and help you reach new listeners via things like press and radio play. But how exactly are the world's biggest music charts calculated? And how many streams do you need to stand a chance to be climbing into these massive music charts? I mean, it's possible for anyone, sonically, who have good music, good quality music, a good strong work ethic, talent, but not forgetting a strong fan base. To stay tuned, and I'll be breaking it down for you throughout this video. So welcome one and all, it's Vital, I'm back, let's keep it moving. Every week we're dropping absolute sauce just for you guys at home. For this video, we'll be speaking about three major global music charts, which is the UK top 40 charts. We'll be speaking about the Billboard charts and also the ARIA charts. And we'll be touching on metrics, numbers and all that good stuff. And of course, there's a lot more charts that we could speak about. But utilizing what we talk about in this video, you can make your own assumptions and metrics cater to something that might be a bit more closer to home. Generally, you'll be able to get more of an understanding of exactly how charts are calculated and what actually counts for a sale and a stream and how it all works all together. But as time goes, the way charts are measured, calculated, and determined will change over time. So in a few years from now, definitely take this with a pinch of salt and understand that things may change and may tweak. We'll also be speaking on how charts calculate data and the different types. And don't forget, I'll be dropping gems here, there, and everywhere. So make sure you stay locked in right up until the end of the video. But just like usual, you know what you can do. You can click down in the timestamps, the chapters, and the markers and move in and around the video if you need to, if you want to go to a certain area. So make sure you check the headings in the description and see if you want to fast forward anywhere. But if not, you know exactly what to do. Sit back, take note, and relax. But before we start, make sure you do one simple thing for me, or maybe three. I'm gonna need you to subscribe to the Ditto Music channel. I'm gonna need you to hit like and make sure you hit that notification bell so you don't miss a single video. And more important than anything, get down in the comments and join the Ditto community where we talk about anything regarding the video. You can ask questions, you can show interest, or you can be down there for some general chit chat. Cool, so you know I'll be in the comments, and without further ado, let's get into this. So how do the official music charts work? Figuring out exactly how the world's biggest music charts actually are determined can be a tricky business. And mainly because of the different factors that come to play and the new ones that keep popping up. So the areas that are involved are download, streaming, radio play, merch bundles, album sales, physical, digital, and other little bits here and there. But I'll give you an overview of how the UK official charts actually work. How are the official UK charts calculated? In regards to the official UK charts, obviously it's all about music, but your music has to be chart registered, because it doesn't matter how much streams and plays and sales you get, if it's not registered, it can't be seen, so therefore it cannot be counted and added to the charts. And with that, obviously comes the music streams, but also accounted for are the streams that you may get from YouTube, for example, of your music videos and audio as well. But with places like Spotify, there's something called variable streaming. So if you are a user, but you have a free Spotify account, compared to a user who has a paid Spotify account, each of your plays are valued differently. So with a paid subscription, that means 100 streams would value one sale. But with a free account, that one sale would equal up to 600 streams. So for example, if your track manages to get 100,000 streams across different audio and video platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, and YouTube, they will be calculated and counted to equal 1,000 sales. But for you to get 1,000 sales from a account that isn't a paid account, you would have to accumulate 600,000 streams just to get 1,000 sales. And obviously it doesn't work as simple or as black and white as that. So a lot of the time your sale count would be a mix and match of paid users who stream and free users who stream. How many sales do I need to get to be in the official UK charts? In recent years, the average UK top 40 single will have had to accumulate around 8,000 sales, while the track that has landed at number one would have to get around 100,000 sales. And the figure for the official UK album charts are similar in ratio, with the average top 40 album selling around 4,000 and the number one album achieving around 60,000 sales, which realistically kind of doesn't seem like a crazy amount. And this is why it's so important to make sure you get your pre-orders in and your pre-sales in, because if you want any chance hitting that 8,000 or that 4,000, it's very doable It's just making sure that you get people to buy and invest in your music, whether it's a pre-sale or pre-order, and if not, within the week of your release. How are the Billboard charts calculated? The Billboard charts are calculated by several different factors, depending on what specific chart. For example, the Billboard Hot 100 and other genre-specific kind of charts take into consideration radio play, streams, and sales. So high-ranking tracks can be driven by one or all of these factors. If you've got a crazy amount of streams, then that could actually take it there. Differently, if you've only got sales or mainly got sales, that also can push it there a lot quicker, doing a lot less work. So you'll have some of the biggest tracks charting due to radio play, while others steadily decline due to the power of streaming. How many sales do I need to get into the Billboard charts? Billboard manages a wide range of charts based on a number of different factors, including physical sales, digital sales, streaming, and radio play. So the issue here that it's quite difficult to pinpoint or give you a rough or even an estimated number of how much sales, streams, radio play, whether it's all of them or individually, you need to actually break the Billboard charts. And because of the four different factors and a wide scope of artists that it actually covers, it's always gonna be quite difficult to pinpoint that exactly. And this is why it's important to just get out there and make it happen. So artists like Drake and Rihanna have no issue because they are so embedded into the culture that it could be old music that's playing that keeps them actually into the charts and not always their new stuff. And this is why sometimes a relatively old song will be in the Billboard charts for weeks and weeks and maybe even months, simply because maybe radio is pushing it. And if it isn't radio, then maybe it's streaming, or maybe it's both of them doing it at the same time. But the point is, if you can kind of get all of those areas, if not get a really solid hold on one or two. How are Australia's ARIA charts calculated? The ARIA charts in Australia, they consider streaming as well as physical and digital download sales. But haven't officially disclosed how streaming counts towards an artist's sell totals and chart position. ARIA also do something quite clever, but not necessarily beneficial for the artists. ARIA state on their website that multiple sales by a single consumer might not be included in an artist's total sales and chart position. And they only accept digital and streaming sales from specific retailers, obviously including the Spotify's, the Apple Music, the Amazon Music, and so on and so forth. So if you are getting a bit of attention in Australia, then the best thing is to make sure that you direct people to the bigger and more known digital and physical outlets. How many sales do I need to get into the ARIA charts? While there isn't a specific number of sales needed to break into the ARIA charts, it has been known to be relatively easy to climb the charts with just having a few thousand sales. Imagine, the ARIA charts recently laid claim to the lowest selling album to ever reach number one in Australia by selling 2,140 copies. So if you can scrape a few hundred sales in Australia, you're more or less going to be in the charts. And I think that's doable if you put your mind to it. Yeah, man, but I just wanted to let you guys know about the different charts and how they work, giving you a little idea, a little piece of information on exactly what is needed to get in the charts, how they work, how they're calculated, and how the different charts work differently and account for different measures and different things. Please remember, the charts are not the be-all and end-all of the music business. There's so much more, so much other ways that people can become successful and live off that. There are plenty of music charts and playlists across Apple Music, iTunes, Spotify, Deezer, Amazon Music, and YouTube Music that might not be seen right now as the best thing ever, but believe you me, if you can hit those charts, there'll be a ricochet effect onto other streaming platforms and potentially into the official charts. And worst case scenario, it will still give your music a massive boost and potentially put some money in your pocket as well. There are artists out there actively living off only streams and YouTube views, as well as the audience that they have accumulated off different social platforms like Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, and TikTok, which some of these artists and creators have never ever seen any chart success at all. So keep creating music and find a space which works best for you, and allow fans to feed into your music and your brand in the best way. In reality, the key is to build your following and promote your music as best as you can, and utilize the mediums when they're there available, like live gigs and doing lives online, social media, email marketing, all those good stuff. So get involved, and don't forget that there's many different ways to be successful. And in the end of the day, it's just down to how you feel. Yes, so I really hope you liked the video. We're touching a few things. We spoke about the charts, from the official UK charts to the Billboard charts to the ARIA charts in Australia, and a bit of understanding of how to, you know, get onto these charts and what it takes, and how they all work a little bit differently. So from me, Vital, and the Ditto team, love and respect every time. Subscribe, like, and comment, and don't forget to hit that notification bell so you don't miss a single video. And I'll see you down in the comments, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace. Love.